How and why do we snore? The main reason we snore, of course, is to attract a mate, and then to ensure that that mate is incapable of sleeping long enough to contemplate running off with anybody else. The good news is that snoring, like belching or blowing your trousers off with a massive guff of arsewind, is perfectly natural, and that most of us, if not all of us, will do it at some time or another. Snoring is caused by vibration in our air passageways as we sleep and as we relax. Basically, it's an unconscious version of the same noise we make to express mild derision, or to imitate a pig. The bad news for anyone trying to sleep next to a snorer is that it's one of the loudest noises a human being can make. Noise levels of up to 92 decibels have been recorded, which means if you're actually trying to share a bedroom with a snorer, you might as well doss down next to a chainsaw. The physiology of snoring is simple enough. We snore when our air passages are slightly blocked, nose or the throat, which causes vibration in the soft palate and the ovular, which is that dangly soft bit at the back of your throat, the bit that's usually misidentified as the tonsils. This obstruction can be caused simply by sleeping at the wrong angle. Lying on your back, for example, makes you far more likely to snore, and it can also be caused by taking too many relaxants, which is a very, very polite, YouTube-y way of saying going to bed drunk. Another common cause is fatty deposits around the throat, which is why one of the common cures for snoring is to do some exercise and lose some weight. But it can also be a symptom of obstructive sleep apnea, which is when your body struggles to breathe while you're asleep. Snoring is something we tend to do as we get older. Not many children snore, but a study of elderly Italians showed that over the age of 60, 40% of women and 60% of men snore, which is not very va bene. Snoring isn't good for us. Loud snorers have an increased risk of stroke and heart attack. But fortunately for us and for those who have to sleep next to us, there are many ways to combat it. To stop snoring, we have to reverse the process, basically unblock the air passageways. And the most drastic way of achieving this is through surgery, with the rather terrifyingly named, wait for it, ovulopalatopharyngoplasty process, which basically involves trimming excess fat out of the throat. Less drastic solutions include non-surgical implants, which just hold the airways open, or even braces to hold your teeth and your tongue in the right position. And even, in the cases of severe apnea sufferers, a positive flow of pressurized air to make sure you breathe. Or there are those little plaster things you wear on your nose, but they make you look a prat.